at the beginning of the 20th century, people realized that medicine should be based on scientific experiments. There was a dramatic event that changed people's way of thinking, and that was the thalidomide tragedy, where you had women who took this drug for nausea during pregnancy, and their children were born without arms and legs.
Every doctor, every hospital, every nurse have been notified. Every woman in this country must be aware that it's most important that they check their medicine cabinet, that they do not take this drug.
And that made people wake up to say, we need to test treatments more effectively. How to make sure that our treatments are doing more good than harm.
En 1991, Gordon Gallat publica un término, un nuevo enfoque para analizar los resultados de estudios clínicos, plantear nuevos métodos y revolucionar la toma de decisiones. Es la medicina basada en la evidencia.
Ordinary people would be surprised that until recently, physicians were not trained at all how to interpret the medical literature.
La medicina basada en la evidencia se hace mundialmente conocida un año más tarde, en 1992, gracias a este artículo publicado en la prestigiosa revista de la Asociación Médica Americana. Se definía así:
to be able to critically look at the medical literature, to be able to distinguish between higher quality evidence and lower quality evidence, to be able to distinguish between trustworthy and less trustworthy, and to be able to make our decisions on the basis of the more trustworthy evidence.
Desde su aparición ha modificado recomendaciones de tratamientos tan extendidos como la utilización de la terapia hormonal sustitutiva durante la menopausia.
The guidelines all said women should take hormone replacement therapy to reduce cardiovascular risk. Then it came along, the randomized trials showed that hormone replacement therapy doesn't reduce cardiovascular risk. Now, had evidence-based medicine been in place, what the women would have been told, maybe hormone replacement therapy reduces your cardiovascular risk, but we're not sure. And maybe it increases your risk of breast cancer, but we are not sure. And maybe it helps your bones and reduces fracture, but we are not sure. Now, are you interested in taking hormone replacement therapy?
Eating processed meat poses the same cancer risk.
Eat processed meat, saying it can cause cancer.
Y su aparición también ha levantado ampollas al poner en duda estudios tan conocidos como el que realizó la Organización Mundial de la Salud, afirmando que la carne roja procesada era cancerígena. Gallat y sus colaboradores publicaron un estudio que ponía en duda esta valoración, afirmaba que la carne roja era una buena fuente de nutrición y pedía a la OMS que revisara sus conclusiones de forma inmediata.
Well, we have criticized what they said about that, and they have not been delighted.
La medicina basada en la evidencia exige un aprendizaje por parte de los médicos que poco a poco empiezan a incorporarla a su práctica clínica.
Which aspect of your next diabetes medication do you want to discuss first?
Pero también la participación de un paciente informado que deberá decidir sobre su propio tratamiento cuando la evidencia sea una duda. Desde su aparición se ha extendido como una nueva filosofía a áreas tan distintas como la educación o la formulación de leyes políticas. Una herramienta tan sólida que, según Gallat, las nuevas formas de obtener datos que aporta el Big Data o la aplicación de la inteligencia artificial no modificarán sus bases. Y para demostrarlo, vuelvo a contar un ejemplo. Esta vez, la medicina basada en la evidencia desmontó que tomar vitaminas antioxidantes como la C o la vitamina E redujera la probabilidad de tener cáncer y enfermedades cardiovasculares.
When randomized trials were done and you randomized people to use the antioxidant vitamins or not, no difference. So what was going on? The people who took antioxidant vitamins were different from the people who didn't take antioxidant vitamins out there in the world. They, things like, they may have had lower stress in their lives, they may have been higher socioeconomic status, they may be eating differently, they may be exercising differently, many differences. And it was those differences, not the antioxidant vitamins, that led them to have lower cancer and lower cardiovascular risk. If we just believed big data, we would all be taking antioxidant vitamins, but it would be doing us no good, right?
Gordon Gallat es ya uno de los 20 científicos más citados de la historia.
I'm pleased.
Y tiene claro cuál es su escuela, lo que quiere transmitir a los futuros innovadores.
A culture of research that is highly collaborative, where people care about one another in research, where they are ready to share their findings openly with one another, where they are ready to listen to one another and work together.